Isn't it a self-fulfilling prophecy that if you issue rules that nobody could meet, that we won't have electricity generation by coal?
One of the reasons why we created a 30-year window was to ensure that there was a pathway forward.
Well, there, at $64 to $102 billion, there is no pathway forward. Let me go. Coal is our most abundant source of low-cost domestic energy. How is taking coal out of our energy mix consistent with the all-the-above energy strategy?
EPA is not preventing either the continued use or the construction of new coal.
Okay, Mr. Barton sent a letter, asked a letter. Department of Energy responded in May 28, 2009, and I quote, "Timeframes for undertaking a project vary depending upon the scale and complexity of the project, with smaller scale projects typically lasting 3 to 4 years in duration, and larger scale, near commercial scale, this is for carbon capture and sequestration projects taking 10 plus years to complete." Now, I'm in one of the largest areas where carbon capture and sequestration is thought to be able to do it, and we're not there. No one's going to go there. Also, on the DOE letter, it says a legal framework is needed to provide certainty in having to deal with ownership of the geological pore space. That's never going to happen. So to think we're going to move to carbon capture and sequestration, it's just very frustrating. And it's not just greenhouse gases. Mr. Barton was correct. Greenhouse gases is the challenge next. What is the electricity generation by coal challenges now? Boiler MAC, mercury MAC, transport rule, coal ash. So, yeah, let's put a new burden on future generation, but you're not admitting the burden that's closing down coal-fired power plants today. So you're already taking the ones out today through current regulation. You're going to take out the next generation of coal through greenhouse gas.